When I started my professional software career, I realized that about 10% of what I learned in college was useful in my professional life. So I thought, what if we had a program that was just teaching that 10%? My name is Sharif Pichet, and I started Dev Bootcamp. Dev Bootcamp is designed for people who are passionate about becoming software engineers, don't have to have a lot of experience, but they have to have enough experience to know that they're going to love it, that they're going to be passionate about it. That's really the main prerequisite for joining Dev Bootcamp.
Dev Bootcamp is an intensive training course taking people from any position in life and teaching them how to become world-class beginner developers. So software engineers, web developers, people who do this a lot.
Some people are like, oh, you're taking a class. It's not really like a class. It's more of, well, a boot camp.
It's really intense, and people put in, you know, maybe 800-900 hours for the duration of Dev Bootcamp. It's an immersive experience, and that's how I like to learn, and so that's the environment that I've created.
We have the students here for 14 hours a day. And one of the reasons that works is because Sharif has created a place where not only is that expected, but it's also fun.
You know, the optimal state of learning is a state of play. If you think of little kids, they're just playing, and that's how they're learning. If we can create an environment where people are essentially playing, they're building stuff that they're enjoying, learning is so much better than an environment where somebody's spouting out knowledge at you.
In a traditional computer science environment in a university, we teach the topics, but we rarely have the opportunity for students to bring those together and build a product out of those topics. Here at Dev Bootcamp, we say, let's build something, and then we teach the topics that are necessary to build that.
My parents, like, their idea was, like, why don't you go and get a master's in computer science? And I worked at a tech company before this, and I would talk to our developers about, like, should I do that? What do you guys think? And they were like, no, like, do not go and get a CS degree. Like, I don't have a CS degree. You don't need one either. You just need to learn how to do it.
Some people are good at learning by themselves, but I think most of us are social learners, and we learn best by being mentored, by working together, trying to solve a problem together, and learning from each other. For sure, you can learn this stuff by yourself, but I think being at Dev Bootcamp really accelerates that learning.
When I was working on my own, I would just get stuck and I'd look on Google and it would take me hours, and by the time I'd figured it out, if I figured it out, I'd be completely frustrated and I'd just quit for the day. Whereas here you can just put your hand up, a mentor will come over, and in 5 minutes you're back on track and you keep moving.
So we have an incredible staff here, and what I look for in staff is basically people who love other people, people who love coding and really get a kick out of sharing that knowledge with other folks.
The promise is that you're going to learn more than you ever thought you could.
It's a big day here at Full Stack Academy. Students are finishing up a coding boot camp.
So Pathfinder's an MPO module.
They range from stay-at-home moms to fresh out of high school.
So right here you see the timeline page, which is where you're able to construct a song.
Kyle Burke was working at an accounting firm and wanted more of a challenge. In 3 months, Burke and his team created Zimmer, an application for users to create music.
So we allow them to create short recordings of audio and then use those audio clips to create a song.
The Academy was founded by David Yang and Nimit Maru. They worked together at Yahoo, left Silicon Valley, and opened the school in Lower Manhattan.
In about 17 weeks, we take an amateur programmer and graduate a software engineer.
Students pay about $15,000 for the three-month program. Today is hiring day, a time for students to demo their final products to potential employers.
We bring in our friends from the technology community, people who've heard us from, and people who are looking for great engineers.
The students will go through a sort of speed dating, if you will, going from table to table, meeting with potential employers, and some of them could get hired right on the spot.
I think this is a very big step, big moment for all of us here at Full Stack.
The average salary for programmers is more than $80,000. Students will finish here with an in-demand skill set and ready to go out and work.
I can step into any job and, you know, have no idea what I'm doing at first, but I know that I have the ability to figure it out. So that's really empowering.
From Lower Manhattan, Liz Dahlem, Fox 5 News.
1 million. My life be like, yeah, ooh. My life be like,
Work it, baby.
Today I'm announcing a new initiative that we're calling Tech Hire. Tech Hire. And it's going to be driven by leaders like you. So there are three big components to this. First, we already have over 20 cities, states, and rural communities from Louisville to Delaware who've signed on to fill tech openings. They've already got more than 120,000 of them in bold new ways. Let me give you an example. Employers tend to recruit people with technology degrees from four-year colleges, and that means sometimes they end up screening out good candidates who don't necessarily have traditional qualifications. They may have learned at a community college, or they may have served in our military. They've got the talent, but employers are missing them. So Tech Hire communities are going to help employers link up and find and hire folks based on their actual skills and not just their resumes. Because it turns out it doesn't matter where you learned code, it just matters how good you are in writing code. If you can do the job, you should get the job. And while four-year degrees in engineering and computer science are still important, we have the opportunity to promote programs that we call, for example, Coding Bootcamp, or online courses that have pioneered new ways to teach tech skills in a fraction of the time and the cost. And these new models have the potential to reach underserved communities, to reach women who are still underrepresented in this sector, and minorities who are still underrepresented in this sector, and veterans who we know can do the job, and lower-income workers who might have the aptitude for tech jobs, but they don't know that these jobs are within reach.
This week, hundreds of thousands of students started classes at colleges and universities. And one thing is increasingly clear. By the time they graduate, most students are going to be leaving with a lot more than just a tacky polyester robe and a copy of Oh, the Places You'll Go that their tearful aunt got them. They'll be leaving with this.
7 of 10 graduating students left college last year in debt. The total bill due for students in America tops $1 trillion.
That's right. Student debt in the US is now bigger than debt from credit cards and auto loans, and is second only to mortgages.
in my head, I'm scared of love. Finding people, listen up. It's never too late to change your love. So don't let them steal your life.